So good morning, my dear students. Today I'm here taking the class of class 7 and we will study the second lesson, that is rise and spread of Islam and its impact. So Islam was followed by the Muslims. Its followers are seen in each part of the world. The name of this Islam was chosen by the Prophet Muhammad, and who was the founder of this religion. So therefore, on the basis of the Arabic word, this means the submission. That means the religion terms Islam means submission to God. Dedicating to God. So Islam is just similar to Christianity, because the Islam used to use the Old Testament, which is given in the Bible, in the Christianity holy book of the Bible, that is Old Testament. The Christianity, the Bible is divided into the two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. And the Old Testament is used by the Islams. So almost this Islam's the holy books that is is similar to the Christianity given by the Jews. And these Muslims believe in a one God that exists only in one God. So they used to share the stories and the traditions. How the Old Testaments of the Christians Bible also share the stories and the traditions. So this is this Islam has become more and more popular because resulting from the successful of the military. The military was so powerful, so this religion became the more and more powerful. Let's see the pre-Islamic times. Before the rise of Islam, the Arab was divided into the many tribes, in many small villages, states, we can say the Kabila. And each tribe of the Kabila was headed by each of the chiefs or head of the community members. So therefore, many Arab tribes were having the life of nomadic, one day from one place to another, moving from one place to another, for searching the food and other types of things. So sometimes they settled in the cities and practice the trade and traditions, or you can say the agriculture. So therefore, each tribe had their own gods, and the goddesses also. They used to worship an idol in a shrine. Once a year, there was Arabia would have put, that is talking about the city of Makkah, and this Makkah is having a cube structure, and that is called the Kaaba. Now let's study about this Kaaba. The Kaaba is the center of the Arabian religious life, and we are going to study about the early life of the Muhammad. This Prophet Muhammad was the last prophet of the Islam. He was the last prophet of the Islam, and he was born in the 570 AD in a city of Arabia. So therefore, that place became more religious, became the lot of religious significance, and it is regarded as the one of the holiest place because the Prophet Muhammad had born in this place. So during his childhood, he lost his parents, and therefore his childhood life became so miserable, so painful. But anyhow, his uncle was there who has brought up his life, but his life was very hard. He grew, when he was living, the people were ignoring the people, very cruel and other things. That made him they were worshipping many gods and goddesses. That made him to think and realize that who is the God and what the God can do it for them, for their special life. Once he was in his childhood life, he had married, and his wife's name was Khalida. In his younger life, he married, and to continue his family, to look after his family, after his marriage, he started working other things. So once he had gone for a study purpose, for a long journey, and when he had gone, he was much attracted by the other people because of his simplicity and the other types of he was very good and genuine and very kind person, very sacrificed person. So within a short of time, he won love and affections, and in the way he was born in the Makkah, that is in talking about in Kaaba. So in the it was the age of 40 where he realized that he should sit in a one holiness place and realize that about the God. And once he has sat there for the meditation, so he understood and felt that there is only one God, that is called Allah. So he also realized and believed that, he felt that God has sent him to do something for the will of God, for the people according to the wish of God. So let's show one. This Momus Rising Paplati became one of the very hostile things. So during the 620 AD, he decided to migrate. Migrate means to go from one place to another place, to go to others. And that moving place of the Muhammad from Makkah to Medina was known as the Hijra. So therefore, he re-entered Makkah in the 630 AD and made it one of the most central, the sanctuaries of the Islam, the shelter of the Islam. Let us see his teachings of the Muhammad. Islam teachings and the principles. It has laid down in a holy book that is called the Quran. And this Quran is recited by the angel, archangel, whose name was Gabriel, who was original copy from the heaven to the Prophet Muhammad. And Prophet Muhammad had preached that there is only one God and we should believe in only one God. We should not worship any kinds of the idol worship. That is, worshipping the idol. Idol things is called as a sin. So he advised the people to surrender to God and also believe in immortality of the soul, and he told that the people can get the life of the eternal happiness unless they are not believing in one God. And if they will donate something, they will help the poor people, that yes, according to the helping the poor people, their life will be purified and all these things. So all believers were equal before him and the God. So that was his teachings. And let's see what he has given for the Muslims to pray, and how many times to pray, what are the pray, the ways to pray it. So this Quran prescribes 5 rupees for every each Muslims. And that the first one is talking about Imam, that is the Urdu word. In English it tells that faith in one God, that is Allah. So all Muslims must recite, must pronounce, must say one, and take the name of Mali and Mali, that is Allah. And the Prophet Muhammad was the apostle of the God. So he declared that all the faithful Muslims are expected to say Shahada. So therefore, the second one is talking about the Salat, that is the prayer. Every Muslim should pray at least 5 times in a day. That first one before the sunset, in the at noon, that is in the afternoon, then late afternoon, then sunset, and after the sunset. And their praying position should be in the towards the direction of Kaaba, and they should, before praying, they should wash their face, and they should clean the hands and the feet and so on. Third one is talking about the zakat, that is talking about the purification. Every Muslim must give alms to the poor. How to purification? Zakat, and this English we say purification, how to purify, how to make our life so holy. That means if you have done something mistake, how you can make our life to be free from the sins and other things. So they used to believe that if you help to the poor people through this way, by doing this, all these things, the man can get purified. Let's see the last one is talking about the swam, or you can say the fasting. Because every Muslim should fast from morning to the evening during the Ramzan times. That is the 9th month of the Islamic calendar. So let's see the Hajj and the pilgrimage to Mecca. All Muslims should visit Mecca at least once in their life, in the lifetimes. If they are strong, if they are not Islam, other people can help them to get the visit of the, or get the chance to visit the this pilgrimage, that is the Makkah place. So therefore, now let's study how the Muslim spread and what was its impact. The Muslim has spread after the death of the this Prophet Muhammad in Arabia and other countries, and his successors were known as the Caliphs. There were 5 caliphs were there. These people became the religious, head of the religious, and the also the head of the Muslim community. The first caliphs were the first four caliphs were there: Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Usman, and Ali. All of them were the companions of the Prophet Muhammad. So Abu Bakr, Umar, Usman, and Ali. These are the four caliphs who just continued the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad after his death. So Abu Bakr and Umar spread this Islam beyond Arabia to Syria, that you can say Iran, Iraq, Jordan, and other places. After that, when the Ali was murdered and even his son also was murdered, this Muslim community divided into the two parts. The first one is the Shia and the second one is Sunni. Shias used to believe that they believed that Caliph should be related to Prophet Muhammad, either by the blood or through any kinds of the relations, maybe by marriage or the some was in the family. But another way, these Sunnis used to believe that this Caliph were chosen by the whole of the world. So that is the two parts of the Shias and the Sunnis. So this, under the leadership of the Caliphs, the Muslims armies conquered different types of the different territories in the West Asia and like Syria, Palestine, Iran, and Egypt, and so on. So they defeated the many countries occupied by Spain, and even they gone into the France. And however, the result was there was the battle of Tours was there near about 732 AD. So let's see what the caliphs have been. Abu Bakr, who succeeded Prophet Muhammad, he was as the caliphs after his death. Umar, Usman, and Ali were the successor of Abu Bakr. So after that, these caliphs, the dynasty started. The first dynasty is called Umayyad dynasty, and this Umayyad dynasty started from the 661 to 750 AD. They moved the administration capital from there, and controlled the administrative power from the capital of Islam from Medina to Damascus in Syria, and they had conquered Spain during the 715 AD. And from the north to the south, they extended their empire from the France, the Sindh, and all other areas. Second one, talking about the Abbasid dynasty. Abbasid belongs to the Shia sect, and they were the patron of the follower of the talking about the Prophet Muhammad. So almost they had took the Islamic empire near about in the 750 AD by overthrowing the Umayyad dynasty, and they started here. The Harun al-Rashid was the most famous ruler for this Abbasid dynasty, and during his rule, the art and these cultures and even the science and literature, everything crossed the glorious more and more. So thank you so much for this today.